and your host of Eagles, head coach Ben Harrington, assistant coach Mitchell Guidry, and coach Kate Falk. At this time, we'd like to ask everyone to remove your caps for our national anthem.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to High School Baseball on KWBJ Live. We're coming to you from Abbeville, Louisiana, at Como Park at Ralph Sellers Fields, where Vermilion High Screaming Eagles are hosting the Hanson Memorial High School Tigers in a district contest here tonight. My name's Aaron Ortego, and I'm here with Chris Hunter. And we're going to bring you some live high school baseball and some of the best Class 1A baseball in the state.
Yeah, Aaron, this is a game with playoff implications for both teams. Vermilion Catholic currently ranked fifth in the power rankings. Pretty much got their first round bye sewed up, second round home field advantage. So they're looking to kind of even enhance their power ranking a little more. A little more at stake for Hanson. They are currently ranked 14th, and they need to get to 12 in order to get a bye in the first round. As it is, at 14, they would be at home in the first round, but they'd love to have that break, get past that first round. Hanson comes into this game with an 18-9 record, 3-2 in district. Vermilion Catholic 16-7, 4-1 in the district, and a three-way tie for the district lead with Central Catholic and Covenant Christian.
Okay, Chris, that's true. The Eagles picked up a forfeit win over Covenant Christian and lost to Central Catholic. So, like I said, you got three teams here, three good high school baseball teams, three good teams that will all make the playoffs, probably in the top 10, if not the top 10, top 12 in the state. So good high-level Class 1A baseball game here today.
The Eagles will send Sam Maya to the round, to the pitcher's mound. He's got a 2-3 record, 2.39 ERA.
Okay, Hanson will lead off the top of the first. Breaking ball misses outside to the leadoff hitter, the shortstop, Ethan Judice. On deck is the left fielder, Lauren Wells, and in the hole, the three-hole hitter is the first baseman, Owen Vaccarella. This pitch, upper level of the strike zone, but in the strike zone for a call, strike one. One ball, one strike. This foul straight back into the fence. Ball in two strikes.
Judice has been the team leader for quite a few years now. Comes in with a .400 batting average, a couple of home runs, 30 RBIs on the year.
This pitch misses low to even the count at two balls and two strikes. This is a line drive right over the third baseman's head for a single. Judice around first base and hold up there with the single. So with a man on first base and nobody out, coming to the plate is left fielder, number 11, Lauren Wells.
Now batting for the Tigers, Lauren Wells.
Mayra, going to first, back in time is Judice.
Wells has cranked his batting average up to 526 on the season.
He has a big lead off first base. Breaking ball comes in for a beautiful call, strike one. Nothing in one is the count. Tigers like to run. Judice has good speed. Maya makes his move to first. Judice is back in easily.
Yeah, Hanson has a team 126 stolen bases on the year.
There he goes. He's going to go all the way to third, and they're going to get him. Yep. He didn't make the tag. He didn't call him until way late, but got a little bit too greedy. Tried to get third base out of it. He had stolen base at second, but then he got caught at third. So that puts one away now, and bases are empty. Ground ball to the first baseman, makes the catch, trots over to first base for the second out. So that's two outs. And I'll bring to the base, to the plate, first baseman Owen Vaccarella.
Now batting for the Tigers, Owen Vaccarella.
Oh, and this curveball doesn't break, and he catches him on the wrist. Vaccarella will be hit by a pitch.
Oh, wait, he might be bringing him back here.
That might be, he's going to call it a foul ball. Ah, he is. He's going to say it got your bat. And he's going to go check with the base umpire now. I don't know, Chris, it's hard to tell from where we're
yeah.
at. But,
from the sound, I would have said it hit him, but you never know when it gets up there. You know, you get up there around the handle and the sound of the bat, it can be muffled.
He's explaining it to him and said, nope, they're going to call it a foul ball.
Break for VC there.
Yep. This breaking ball catches the outside corner for a call, strike two. Nothing in two to count on Vaccarella. Ground ball down the third baseline. It's going to be foul. Count will stay. Nothing in two on Vaccarella with two outs and nobody on base.
Got it.
This fastball on the outside corner for a call, strike three. And turns out to be three up. Gave up a base hit, but it's still three up and three down.
I'd like to thank some of our sponsors.
Yep, that's an efficient inning for Maya. Like I said, he gives up the leadoff hit, but he gets some good defense behind him. Not many pitches either.
No, but one strikeout and like I said, a caught stealing, and he got a hit early in the count.
We mentioned VC in a three-way tie for the lead in the district with Central Catholic and Covenant Christian. They lost to Central Catholic last time out. I got the score here somewhere. 6-0. That was on Tuesday. Central Catholic won that game, and that snapped a 8-game win streak for VC. Covenant Christian beat Central Catholic for their only loss. And as you mentioned, VC's, or Covenant Christian's only loss in district was to VC, and that came on a forfeit due to illegal use of a pitcher. A relief pitcher came in and went one pitch over his limit for the week.
Wow. One pitch as, too many.
As I'm told, for me and Catholic coach Ben Harrington is he's a baseball rule book. He's a walking baseball rule book. He's kind of like Aaron Odegaard. And he was right on top of it as soon as he went over. He brought that to the umpire's attention. Game over.
Well, I noticed they had had a forfeit. I didn't know why. That explains it.
That's why.
Okay, we go to the bottom of the first inning. And the first three hitters for the Vermilion Catholic Screaming Eagles will start off with their right fielder, Jonathan Dorcas, followed by the pitcher, Sam Maya, and first baseman, Jackson Trahan.
I don't have a team batting average for Vermilion Catholic, but like Hanson, they have got a lot of guys in the lineup that can bash the ball around. Jonathan Dorcas is one of them. He leads the team with a .400 average, a couple of doubles and a home run on the season.
Dorcas.
First pitch to Dorcas is low for a ball one. This one's up high a little bit for a ball two. Two balls, no strikes. Right fielder Jonathan Dorcas at the plate, and this one's going to hit him a breaking ball, stays inside. And Dorcas will draw the hit batter, base on. So runner will stand, Dorcas will stand on first base as today's starting pitcher, Sam Maya, comes to the plate. He'll bat with nobody out. Fauché goes to first base.
Well, last week we saw Fauché get off to a shaky start against Central Catholic as well. It knocked him around a little bit in the first inning.
Uh-oh. Looks like ball gets away. The line drive to the third baseman. Makes the catch. Throws down to first. Try to pick off the base runner. Ball gets away from the first baseman. And Dorcas ends up at third base. That'd be an error on third baseman.
And as I was about to say, Central put the bats on him early, but what really happened was poor defense. And sure enough, there's a two-base error that puts the lead runner in scoring position for Vermilion Catholic.
So one out, now batting.
Yeah. Just like that, pass ball. And VC's on the board.
Of course, the pitch was a ball. At the plate is Trahan. This fastball catches the outside corner for a call strike one. One ball, one strike, one out. Bases are empty. Swings at the curve ball. And it's a ground ball down the first baseline, foul.
Central Catholic was up on Hanson and Fauché 4-0 before he really knew what was going on. But once he settled down, he pitched well for a few innings. So now the job here is to minimize the damage of this poor start.
Again, ahead of the pitch, and he grounds it down the first baseline towards first base dugout, foul. Nothing in two to count. Swing and a miss, gets away from the catch. He throws down to first base in time. It'll be a strikeout in the second out. So with two outs, cleanup hitter and left fielder, Bryce Leger, will come to the plate.
Batting for the Eagles, Bryce Leger.
Leger, strike one.
Leger comes in hitting .323 on the year.
This is fouled straight back into the fence. Nothing in two. Leger bats in the cleanup spot, four hole. On deck is their second baseman, Arden Bayrou. This off the end of the bat in the dirt, bounces toward the on deck circle. Count will stay, nothing in two. This is a ground ball hitting the hole between short and third. It gets through for a single. So the Eagles get their first hit of the ball game. Leger will stand on first base as the five-hole hitter, Arden Bayrou. And Bayrou is the second baseman. Two outs, runner on first. Fastball misses outside. Ball one.
Bayrou is a 371 hitter, 16 RBI.
Swings at this one and tips it into the catcher's glove for a foul tip. And one ball, one strike. Boucher goes to first, and Leger back in time. Leger is a left fielder, so we're going to assume he's got some good wheels. He gets a healthy lead. This bounces about 5 feet in front of the plate. Ball two, two balls and a strike.
Well, despite that, Boucher looks like he's in good command of his pitches so far today.
Swing and a miss. Strike two. Two balls, two strikes, two out, one on base. Base runner's Bryce Leger stands on first base. Big lead. This popped up straight back over the press box. Count stays two and two. Shadows are starting to creep in. Home plate is in the shadow. The rest of the field is in the sun. The setting sun will be in the eyes of the fielders on the left side of the field here. Shortstop, third baseman, left fielders. They'll be looking right into that sun.
And a pretty steady breeze blowing out to right field.
Have a full count, two outs. This line drive just fouled down the third base line. Count will stay full.
Bayrou getting his money's worth in this at bat.
Boucher checks the runner, throws the first. Leger back in time. It's a ground ball to second. It's picked up, goes to first, in time for the third out. So they got one run on one hit. They take a 1-0 lead after one complete inning of play.
Now let's take a moment to thank a few of our sponsors. Lapco Manufacturing. Feel safe, work smart, look good with Lapco FR. www.lapco.com. Taco Bell in Morgan City and Bayou Vista. Open late night, delivery through DoorDash. Bayou Bend Fitness Center, 1209 Northwest Boulevard in Franklin. A healthier you begins at Bayou Bend. Conrad Industries, serving St. Mary Parish and the marine industry since 1948. Conrad wishes all of our local teams good luck. Core Physical Therapy and Sports Performance, here to restore the quality of life you deserve. 611 Brashear Avenue in Morgan City.
Searching through the mud to find the present, no ignoring.
Okay, we'll move to the top of the second inning. Leading off the top of the second inning will be the cleanup hitter and pitcher, Carter Foshay, followed by center fielder Dan Ibert, and the catcher, Ethan Clements, will be in the hole.
Hope you've been enjoying this season of high school baseball with us on KWBJ Live. Try to bring you a lot of out-of-town games here, get you to some of the games that you might have had difficulty getting to. And this is one I've been looking forward to, Ralph Sellers Field. This is an iconic Louisiana high school baseball field, not just high school, but youth baseball. This some of the old-timers will remember that this ball field hosted the Babe Ruth World Series twice, once back in the 70s and once in the 80s.
Foshay grounds the first pitch to the third baseman, Prejean, who makes the catch and throws the first in time for the first out. That'll bring to the plate center fielder Dan Ibert. He'll bat with one out, and the base is empty. This pitch, a little bit low, ball one. Ibert bats in the five hole. This is a ground ball to second, makes the catch, flips the first in time. Nice play by second baseman Bayro.
Yeah, he had to go a long way to get to that one.
So two up, two down, and that'll bring to the plate the catcher, Ethan Clements.
Now batting, Ethan Clements.
Yes, a fastball at the knees on the inside part of the plate for a call. Strike one. This is popped up. Going deep, deep, deep. It's going to get over the left fielder's head. And Clements slides into second for the double. So the Tigers get their second hit of the game. Ethan Clements will stand on second base with two outs. And the DH coming to the plate, that's Reed Lovell.
Reed Lovell.
Lovell bats in the seven hole. Curveball gets away from the catcher, throws down to third. Ball is, gets there in time, but Ibert slides underneath the tag. So Ibert now stands on third base. The pitch was a ball. 1-0 count on Lovell. This pitch misses inside. Ball two. Tying run standing on third base is Ethan Clements. This gets over the left fielder again. One run will score. On his way to second base, sliding under the tag is Reed Lovell, the DH. So back-to-back doubles lead to one run. And that'll bring to the plate the eight-hole hitter and right fielder,
now batting, Trey Edwards.
And we mentioned the sun. I'm wondering if the left fielder is having difficulty with the sun, because his break on both of those balls looked like he thought it was coming straight to him, and then all of a sudden he had to angle back as the ball got over his head.
See, Chris, too, also both of those hits, especially the second one, was line drives. To where, you know, it makes it even harder to see in that sun, in the setting sun, because he's looking right in it. You can see him standing out there right now, shading his eyes with his gloves. So it's definitely a factor. This pitch fouled off into the fence. Nothing in two to count on Edwards. Again. Fouled back into the fence. Count stays, nothing in two.
Edmonds hitting 279 on the year. Just eight RBIs, so he's got an opportunity here.
Ground ball to third, comes up with it, makes the catch, throws the first in time. That's Frazier on third base for the third out.
I'd like to thank some of our sponsors.
And Hanson gets on the board. Buckle up, Aaron. We got us a ball game.
Yeah, well, that's kind of what we was expecting, and that's what we're getting. We've got a tie ball game, 1-1, in the middle of the second inning. Tigers pick up two hits, a couple doubles, back-to-back doubles, and get the run in. We move to the bottom of the second inning. First three hitters for the Eagles will be their third baseman. Six-hole hitter, Andrew Prejean, be followed by shortstop Ethan Landry, and then the catcher, Jacob Dubois.
And tomorrow we are right back on the road, our last regular season game of the year. We're heading down to Matthews for a non-district game between the Central Catholic Eagles and the Central Lafourche Trojans. Official start time for that game is 6 o'clock. However, it's going to be the second game of a doubleheader. The first game starts at 4. We're only doing the second game, so time might be approximate there, but we're figuring around 6 o'clock.
That's the scheduled time for our anyway, so if they can get the first one done in a couple hours, we'd probably have to get it done in an hour and a half, which probably won't happen. Because they generally like to take a little break in between games. It's a breaking ball that catches the inside corner for a call, strike one. Fauché stays on the mound for the Tigers. Fastball, ground ball down the third baseline, gets under the third baseman's glove. Tried to backhand it.
Yeah, got to get in front of that.
So Prejean will be safe at first base on the error. That'll bring the shortstop, Ethan Landry, to the plate.
Now batting, Ethan Landry.
He'll bat with nobody out. I think the scoreboard has two outs, but I don't think that's correct.
No.
Because we only had one batter. This is the second batter, and nobody's out. He tried to lay down the bunt, rolls foul down to the third baseline. Nothing in two.
Is it 02 or 01?
I had a school board saying 02. It had 01 before.
I thought that
pitch.
Was the first pitch to him.
Might have been. This pitch misses low. For a ball. Okay, now you were right. It's one ball, one strike.
I get lucky now and then.
Yeah. Swing and a miss. Actually, it's a foul tip. One ball, two strikes. Prejean stands on first base. Has a good lead. Breaking ball misses inside. Evens the count. Two balls, two strikes. This pitch misses outside. Runs the count full. We got a full count. Fauché goes the first. Prejean back standing up. This ground ball down the first baseline, foul. Count stays full. Another foul ball straight back into the fence. We'll do it all over again. Still full. Swing and a miss.
Caught it. Yep.
Caught it. Yep, for the strike. So Landry goes down swinging for the first out.
It's another batter making Foshay use a lot of pitches.
That'll bring to the plate today's starting catcher and eight-hole hitter, Jacob Dubois. Dubois gets the bunt down. The only play will be at first. And getting there just in time is Vaccarella for the second out and a successful sacrifice bunt. Two away. That'll bring to the plate center fielder and nine-hole hitter is Ross D'Artes. This pitch misses low for ball one. 1-0 to count.
You know, that's the right play by Vaccarella at first base to take that himself, because by the time it might have become necessary to throw it, it was just too close.
Well, it was pretty darn close, taking it unassisted.
It ended up being a close play, but if you're that close to the second baseman who's covering, you run a chance of it being bobbled if you try to toss it to him.
But he beat him by a half a step. Breaking ball, trying to get the bunt down. He's bunting for the hit because it's two outs. It rolls foul down the third baseline. One ball, two strikes. Two outs with Prejean standing on second base. Swing and a miss for strike three. So D'Artes goes down swinging to end the inning.
I'd like to thank some of our sponsors, Aqua Splash Pool Care. Thank you for your support.
So no runs and no hits. The score after two complete innings of play. Hanson Tigers, 1. Vermilion Catholic Screaming Eagles, 1.
And shout out to a few of our sponsors. Core Physical Therapy and Sports Performance, here to restore the quality of life you deserve. 611 Brasher Avenue in Morgan City. Patterson State Bank, free checking, great rates, low down payment home loan options, and the best in mobile banking. PSB, quality community banking since 1925. GJCurbside.com. Hang on, I got to pick up the paper. Your complete online grocery store, including local and regional products. Check our website for delivery options. From our curb to yours, GJ Curbside. Ochsner St. Mary, quality health care close to home. Lafayette Electric, 1207 Greenwood Street in Morgan City, proud supporter of high school baseball in the Tri-City area. And Allen's Communications, locally owned TV, cable, internet, and telephone service. Call 384-8335. Thanks to all of our sponsors.
Okay, we'll move to the top of the third inning. And the Tigers will start it off with the nine-hole hitter and second baseman at Spencer Fuhrer. Then we'll move to the top of the batting order with Ethan Judice, followed by Lauren Wells. Same Maya stays on the mound for the Eagles. Fastball right down the middle of the plate for a call, strike one. Breaking ball this time for a call, strike two. Nothing in two to count on Fuhrer. And that, he's going to call a ball. Nope. Looked pretty good, though, from here, huh, Chris?
Catcher liked it.
Yeah. One ball, two strikes. That's an awful close pitch to take with two strikes, whether it's a ball or a strike.
And Fuhrer does the right thing. Stands in there, makes the umpire make a call.
Yep. Ground ball hit to second baseman. Flips it to first in time. That's Bayrow over there making the play for the first out.
Barrow again having to range a long way to his left to make that play.
That'll take the Tigers to the top
now
of the batting
Ethan
order.
Judice.
And Ethan Judice, who singled to left field to start the game. He got thrown out at third, trying to take two bases on a pass ball. Or a stolen base, rather, and a pass ball. This fastball catches the outside corner for a call strike one. And breaking ball misses low. Evens the count, one ball, one strike. Nobody on base, one out. His fastball on the outside corner for a call strike two. One ball, two strikes. Ooh, another close one to take, but he did. Evens the count at two balls and two strikes.
Now, when you're a 400 hitter, you have demonstrated knowledge of the strike zone, among other things.
Yeah, but when you got two strikes and it's close, I don't want the umpire to call it, okay?
I've never hit 400.
Yeah. Yeah, not a lot of people have. Full count. And this miss is off the plate, so Judice will draw the walk. He'll trot down to first base with one away. And Judice on first base, that'll bring to the plate the left fielder,
now batting
Lauren Wells. Wells grounded out to first base in the first inning. It's a breaking ball, misses low and away.
Remember in the first inning, Judice was in the process of stealing a base, and the pitch turned out to be a pass ball. Got a little greedy and tried for third all the way from first, but the catcher, Dubois, made a nice throw and got him at picked him off at third.
He actually got there, slid under the tag, but he overslid the bag, then got tagged out. The 1-0 pitch. Fastball. Evens the count at a ball and a strike. This pitch misses low and away. For ball two, two balls and a strike. This is popped up high, right field, comes up on it, and makes the catch for the second out. With two outs and runner on first base, that'll bring to the plate first baseman Owen Vaccarella. Vaccarella struck out looking in the first inning. Mayock goes to first. Judice back in time. Judice is going. It's a breaking ball. The throw down to second is high. Judice slides in with a stolen base. So Judice with his second stolen base of the day. He'll now stand on second base with two outs.
And that brings him to 20 stolen bases on the year.
The pitch was a call strike, breaking ball for a call strike. There's a ground ball hit right up the middle. They're going to send Judice home. Center fielder's coming home with the throw and sliding under the tag. He had already touched the plate and was safe. So Judice, the stolen base, pays off as he scores. And he was gone, Chris, with two outs. He was gone on contact. Of course, there's a ground ball up the middle. He'd have been running anyway. But the coach was sending him all the way. And they got him in. Vaccarella singles, picks up an RBI.
Now batting Carter Foshia.
That'll bring to the plate today's pitcher, Carter Foshia. Foshia grounded out to third base to start the second inning. This is a ground ball, backhanded by the shortstop, goes to first base in time. Nice place over the play over there at short by Landry for the third out. But the Tigers get one hit and one run to take a one-run lead.
Not sure what happened here.
We'd like to thank the umpire sponsors, Big
did not like something
and Abbeville that, chiropractic care.
That the pitcher did or said coming off the mound. Having a discussion with Coach Harrington now. I'm not sure what happened.
Like a pretty intense discussion over there, Chris. I said we had no idea what they were talking about. Umpire made his point. And we'll move to the bottom half of the third inning. The Tigers lead the Eagles by a score of 2-1. To start off the bottom of the third, Vermilion Catholic will go to the top of their batting order with the leadoff hitter, Jonathan Dortas, be followed by the pitcher, Sam Maya, and first baseman, Jackson Trahan. Dortas, leadoff hitter, got hit by a pitch in the first inning and scored the Eagles' run of the first run of the game. Boucher stays on the mound for the Tigers.
Of course, it's early, but he's had to use a lot of pitches to get through those first two innings. Not sure. We don't have a pitch count.
No, but in the first two innings, he did face a total of 9 hitters.
It felt like he used a lot of pitches.
He saw 5 hitters in the first inning and 4 in the second inning. Had a lot of full counts.
Lead off for the Eagles.
A lot of foul balls on them full counts. This is a breaking ball, stays way inside and hits Dortas. That's the second time today. He's batted twice, got hit by a pitch both times. He was staying on first base with nobody out. Maya. It's spelled not like it's pronounced, folks. It's ground ball by Mayara in the hole between short and third for the single. So Maya singles, puts runners on first and second with nobody out. And coming to the plate, the first baseman, Jackson Trahan. Trahan struck out swinging in the first inning.
Now batting, Jackson Trahan.
First pitch outside, ball one.
Trahan, a 344 hitter coming into the game.
Gets a butt down third base, nowhere to go. Spangler at third, wisely just puts it in his pocket.
Yeah, nothing he can do there.
It'll be an infield hit.
Conventional wisdom tells you that they were bunting for the sacrifice there, but that's a base hit all the way.
Put it in the right spot. That'll bring to the plate the cleanup hitter, Bryce Leger. Leger's the left fielder. He singled. And this is a ground ball up the middle to second for one, to first on the hop in time to get the double play, but a run scores.
Or you gave up the run, but you got the double play. Which,
yep. Both, you notice both sets of fans applauded for that.
Now batting, Aiden Barrow.
Two outs, second baseman. Aiden Bayrou at the plate. He grounded out to second base in the first inning. This is popped up down the third baseline and out of play. Breaking ball, swing and a miss. Strike two. One ball, two strikes. Two outs with a runner on third. Swing and a miss, but it's a foul ball. Wasn't a swing and a miss. He did get a little piece of it. Keeps him alive. One ball, two strikes. That pitch misses. Evens the count at two and two. Two balls, two strikes, two outs with one on. It's a curveball in the dirt. Gets away from the catcher. The run will score. That's Maya. That scores. Eagles take a 3-2 lead. Bases are empty and the count is full. This is a fastball on the inside corner for a call strike three. Bayrou didn't like it, but it doesn't change anything.
I'd like to thank some of our sponsors, A's Dumpster Rentals and the Bank
of the Bayrou goes Thanks down looking for the third out, but not before the Screaming Eagles pick up two runs and two hits and one hit by pitcher. So after three complete innings of play, Hanson Memorial Tigers 2, Vermilion Catholic Screaming Eagles 3.
If you look at this beautiful Ralph Sellers Field, like we said, this is one of the better high school baseball fields in South Louisiana. So room for seating for a lot of people. Of course, you notice everybody seems to choose to bring the lawn chairs. Sooner or later, somebody's going to come up with a ballpark where you don't have grandstands. You just kind of build a levee around infield, and everybody will bring chairs.
Hey, and to start off the fourth inning, as we move to the top of the fourth, the Tigers will do that with their center fielder and five-hole hitter, Dan Ibert, followed by the catcher, Ethan Clements, and the DH, Reed Lovell. Ibert is the five-hole hitter. He grounded out to second base back in the second inning. Ground ball to second base, makes the catch and throws over is Bayrou. One pitch, one out.
Bayrou's getting a lot of work over there at second base.
Yeah, he's made all the plays, too. So with one away, catcher Ethan Clements, who singled and scored a run in the second inning. He didn't single, he doubled in the second inning and scored a run. First pitch is called strike one.
That started what looked to be a nice rally as Hanson got back-to-back doubles to get their first run of the game on the board.
Swing and a miss at the breaking ball. Nothing in two. That's a breaking ball that's off the corner, the outside corner for ball one. And this was a breaking ball in the dirt. But Dubois makes the catch, picks the ball up, throws him out at first base. So Clemens goes down swinging for the second out. So with two outs and nobody on base, DH Reed Lovell will come to the plate. Lovell bats in the place of third baseman Luke Spangler. This popped up down the first baseline, but foul. No balls, one strike. Ground ball to short, makes the catch, flips to first in time. Nice play by Landry at shortstop. It's three up, three down for the Tigers. So we're in the middle of the fourth inning.
And
Tigers
again,
it's two, Eagles three.
It's an efficient inning for Maya. I think ideally, you start to get a little concerned when you get up over 15 pitches in an inning, and I know he hadn't even approached that in any inning. Don't have a count. Well, maybe in the second inning when Hanson strung some hits together, but for the most part he has not had to use many pitches tonight.
They saw five hitters in the second inning, three hitters in the first, three hitters in the fourth, and five hitters in the third. First and fourth had three hitters each. Second and third had five hitters each.
Coming into the final weekend of the regular season, I'm not sure what day the playoff brackets will be announced, but should be having first round games late next week into the weekend. Not sure what we'll be doing as far as coverage yet. We're going to wait to see who's in, who's where, and when they're playing. But stay with us on our KWBJ TV 22 Facebook page for an announcement on what we'll be doing.
Lead off the Eagles, Andrew
Frazier. For the Eagles, leading off the bottom of the fourth is third baseman Andrew Frazier. Frazier reached on an error, died on second base in the second inning. Swing and a miss. Ball and a strike. And another swing and miss. Ball in two strike. Going after them breaking balls, not catching them. One ball, two strikes. This popped up. Second baseman calls for it. Right where the dirt meets the grass, if it was dirt. It's a turf infield. That's Fuhrer at second base making the play. So with one out, shortstop Ethan Landry will come to the plate.
Haven't mentioned this is an artificial turf infield.
Yep. Fastball catches the inside corner for a call strike one on Landry. Landry is the shortstop. Landry struck out swinging in the second inning. This is a ground ball to Fuhrer at second base, makes the catch. Throws to first for the second out.
Bill Nye the Science Guy.
With two outs, that'll bring to the plate the eight-hole hitter and catcher, Jacob Dubois. Dubois had a sacrifice bunt, a successful sacrifice bunt in the second inning. First pitch is a ball. Second pitch in the dirt. Ball 2-0. This pitch inside. Ball 3. 3-0 is a count on catcher Jacob Dubois. Ball Fastball. Dubois looked like he was taking that one all the way. Three balls and a strike. Ground ball to third. Spangler at third. Makes the catch. Throws the first in time. Three up, three down for Fauché.
Like thanks to our sponsors.
So we've played four complete innings
of
play.
Thank you for the support of Vermilion Catholic Screaming Eagles.
And it's Hanson Tigers 2, Vermilion Catholic Screaming Eagles.
And thanks to some of our sponsors, Lapco Manufacturing. Feel safe, work smart, look good with Lapco FR. www.lapco.com. Taco Bell in Morgan City and Bayou Vista. Open late night, delivery through DoorDash. Bayou Bend Fitness Center, 1209 Northwest Boulevard in Franklin. A healthier you begins at Bayou Bend. Conrad Industries, serving St. Mary Parish and the marine industry since 1948. Conrad wishes all of our local teams good luck. Core Physical Therapy and Sports Performance, here to restore the quality of life you deserve. 611 Brasher Avenue in Morgan City.
Top of the fifth inning, the Tigers will start it off with their eight-hole hitter and right fielder, Trey Edwards, followed by second baseman Spencer Fuhrer. Then we'll move to the top of the batting order in Ethan Judice. Edwards grounded out to the third baseman back in the second inning. Shadows are starting to move into the infield a little bit as the first baseline and third baselines are in the shadows now. Still a tough spot for that left fielder out there. Right. Actually, the whole left side of the fielders, they're all looking into the sun.
Yeah, the sun not quite low enough that it's not having an effect.
Right. Mayo's first pitch is a ball. Second pitch is a fastball on the outside corner for a call. Strike one. One ball, one strike. There's a breaking ball that's a little bit low. Two balls and a strike.
Tell you something else I like about Ralph Sellers Field here, Aaron. Unobstructed view, foul pole to foul pole. That has not always been the case.
Nope.
Some of the ballparks we've come to this year.
Well, usually we sit a lot lower than we are today.
Yeah.
Too. That helps. This is a ground ball that's going to get in the hole between short and third for the single. So Trey Edwards will start off the top of the fifth with the single. And that'll bring to the plate nine-hole hitter and second baseman Spencer Fuhrer. Fuhrer grounded out to the second base in the third inning. Nobody out. Runner on first. Trying to get the bunt down, but it's going to be foul. Nothing and one count on Fuhrer.
Now batting Spencer Fuhrer.
Close.
Very close. Yep. Very. That's one I had to wait for the umpire to make a call because from here it looked like he could have called either way.
Whole lot of umpires in the Vermilion Catholic side of the field that thought he was out.
It was plenty close enough to be. Nothing in one is the count on Fuhrer. Looking to bunt, but the pitch was up high. Ball one. One ball, one strike. Maya goes first again. Edwards back in time. Edwards out there with a big lead. He's a right fielder. He's got a stance. Looks like he wants to get down there. And again, Fuhrer trying to bunt it down the first baseline, but it's foul. So one ball, two strikes. Pitch up high, high and inside. Ball two, two balls, two strikes. Swing and a miss. Edwards is going down to second base, and he has a stolen base as Fuhrer goes down swinging. For the first out, Edwards with the stolen base will move to second base. And we'll move to the top of the batting order in Ethan Judice. Judice singled and stole a base. Got caught at third in the first inning. And he walked, stole a base, and scored a run in the third inning. So one for one on the day. Maya goes to second base. Edwards is back easily. One of those throws over Chris just, hey, I want you to know I'm watching.
I see you.
Ground ball hit up the middle. Nice play at short. The throw is off the mark. Gets away from the first baseman. They're going to send a runner home. He's going to slide under the tag. And Edwards is safe. So Landry makes an outstanding catch of the ball. Comes up, but his throw's off the mark. So Judice will be safe at first.
Yeah, very nice glove work at shortstop, but the throw got away. Edmonds on his horse from the start. Had us a few plays at the plate here in this game, isn't it?
Yeah, some
a little
close
bit of
plays.
Everything.
Yeah, that was some close plays. So Edwards scores to tie the ball game at 3. First pitch is a call strike 1.
We were hoping for a good one. We've got it.
At the plate is left fielder Lauren Wells. Wells is 0-for-2 on the day. He hit a ground ball out to the first baseman and flied out to right field. Judice stands on first. Judice is going, but it's a foul ball. He'll have to go back. He's 2-for-2 on stolen bases today. One ball, 2 strikes. Pitch misses outside. Well, the scoreboard is saying 1-2-2, but the umpire is saying 1-2. Now the scoreboard agrees. 1-2. One ball, 2 strikes. Judice is going, and the throw is high, and he has another stolen base, but Wells goes down swinging. So Judice picks up his 3rd stolen base today.
Now batting Owen Vaccarella.
That'll bring to the plate the first baseman, Owen Vaccarella. Vaccarella is 1-for-2. He thought he got hit by a pitch, but they decided to call it a foul ball. This is a fly ball hit to center fielder. Out there as D'Artes comes up and makes the catch for the 3rd out. Okay. Now we're in the middle of the 5th inning. Tigers 3, Eagles 3. Tie ball game as we move to the bottom of the 5th. Bottom of the 5th, the Eagles will start off with their 9-hole hitter and center fielder who just made the running catch, Ross D'Artes. Then they'll move to the top of the batting order in Jonathan D'Artes, the right fielder, followed by the pitcher, Sam Maya. Maya.
Again, we've got a 3-way tie for the lead in District 7-1A. Vermilion Catholic, Central Catholic, Covenant Christian, all 4-1 records coming into tonight's game, and this will be the last game. Central is at Highland Baptist, and I think they will win that one. That's a prediction. Covenant Christian, I'm not sure who they play tonight, or if they play tonight at all. I think Centerville is the only team that will be left. So if there's a district game tonight, it's Centerville.
Roche staying on the mound.
Eagles, Ross D'Artes.
D'Artes fouls off the first pitch. D'Artes struck out swinging in the second inning. Nothing in one to pitch. And this is going to hit him. So the nine-hole hitter gets hit by a pitch. Ends up on first base. There's a breaking ball that stayed inside. There's a runner on first base and nobody out. Moved to the top of the batting order, and Jonathan D'Artes.
Cardinal sin for the pitcher. It's to give the nine-hole hitter a free base. That'll bring Coach Case and Knight out to have a discussion. I don't think he's coming out.
Doesn't look like it because the only people on the mound is pitcher and catcher. Just kind of wants to settle him down a little bit. This is his fifth inning of work. And he's now starting on the third time through the batting order.
Yeah, and now you got a tie ball game in the top of the order coming up.
Jonathan D'Artes. Ross D'Artes stands on first base, and this is Jonathan D'Artes at the plate. Been hit by a pitch twice. D'Artes going down to second. The throw is high, and D'Artes has a stolen base. So he'll stand on second base with nobody out. Pitch was a ball. Yeah, Jonathan has been hit twice and scored both times. There's a breaking ball that misses. Or did he call it a strike?
Strike.
It was a strike? Okay. One ball, one strike. This pitch is in the dirt. And D'Artes, that's on the bases, will go to third. D'Artes at the plate has a two ball, one strike count. So Ross D'Artes stands on third base with nobody out. Jonathan D'Artes pitches in the dirt for ball three, three balls and a strike. This is a little soft liner that's going to drop in front of the center field to score a run. So Jonathan D'Artes singles, gets the RBI. Ross D'Artes scores a run, reaches base on a hit by pitch. And of the four runs that the Eagles have, three of those runs got on base by hit by pitch.
Now batting, Sam Maya.
That'll bring to the plate the pitcher, Sam Maya. Breaking ball that misses just off the plate. One ball, no strikes.
And I'm afraid Foshe might be starting to run out of gas.
Yeah. Maya is one for two. Okay, this pitch gets away from the catcher Clements. Runner goes to second. And Maya singled and scored a run in the third. And he hit a line drive right at the third baseman in the first. Or an out. He's got a 3-0 count. And that misses, I guess. It looked pretty good from here, but
four
it's
pitch walk.
We're going to say it was low, I guess. And definitely over the plate. So Maya draws the walk. Runners on first and second. And this will be a pitch and change as it's the second trip this inning. Nobody out. One run in, two runs on base.
Looks like they're gonna go to Judy's here.
Now pitching for the Tigers, number 5, Ethan Judice.
Okay.
We have seen Ethan Judice a few times. He come into this game with a 3-2 record. 1.5 ERA in 27.2 innings pitched. He's got 58 strikeouts and 35 walks on the year. Team's bat just 0-6-3 against him. He has been, he's been a weapon on the mound for the Tigers.
Let's see what other defensive changes if we can pick them up. Of course, they're all standing together right behind second base right now as Judice takes his warm-up tosses. You saw Judice come in last week against the Eagles. I want to say it was the fourth inning or fifth inning. And they do it here in the bottom of the fifth.
Unfortunately, I am standing right behind these speakers. And when the music's playing, I can't hear a word Aaron's saying.
Okay. Looks like Edwards has moved in from right field to
Jackson
second base. And maybe Fuhrer, I guess, went over at short. I'm not sure. And Fauché went to first base, did he? And it gets the bunt down. That's Trahan at the plate, but it's foul. Trahan is 1-for-2 on the day. He struck out swinging in the first inning, and he singled back in the third. Trahan is the first baseman for the Eagles. This is fouled in the dirt. Rolled back to the backstop. Nothing in two.
Hanson has two regular season games left, both scheduled for the purpose of enhancing their power ratings at the end of the year. Saturday, they will be hosting Slidell, who is going to make the playoffs in Division I non-select. And on Monday, they will travel to New Iberia, probably not a playoff team, but another Division I opponent.
Swing and a miss. It's in the dirt, but there's a runner on first base, so he cannot advance. Trahan strikes out swinging for the first out. That'll bring to the plate the cleanup hitter in left field of Bryce Leger. Leger is 1-for-2 on the day. He singled in the first inning and hit into double play starting at 6-4-3. Shortstop to second base to first base. First pitch misses low. 1-0. One out. Runners on first and second base. One run has scored so far this inning. This pitch misses low and away. 2-0 to count to Leger. We're in the bottom of the fifth. 4-3, Eagles lead over the Tigers. It's a fastball that misses low. This pitch misses for ball three.
Nope, that was a strike.
Well, that one was a strike.
On a 3-0.
Oh, 3-0, okay.
So we got 3-1 now.
I'm trying to pick up those defensive changes out there. Swing and a miss for strike two. Full count. Full count with one out and runners on first and second.
It's number 8 at shortstop, and I don't have a number 8 on my roster.
I think that's Fuhrer.
Okay.
Yeah, that is Fuhrer. He was playing second base. Ground ball right to him. Going to flip to second for one out to first base. Not in time. It's going to get away from the first baseman. They're going to throw back down to second. They're going to get him at second, but the run will score.
And that's both a throwing error and a mental error on the part of it. Well, no. What's happening here?
Well, that was the third out. Made it second base.
Oh, I only had one out.
Well, was,
oh, I forgot to mark the second out on
play
the strikeout.
He got the force out at second. Okay, and then the throw was off, and he went to second base, and then he caught him. He actually made two outs at second base.
All right, but the run scored.
The run
they
scored.
Counted it.
Eagles pick up two runs.
Quick shout out to sponsors. How about that, Aaron?
Sounds like a good deal.
Patterson State Bank, free checking, great rates, low down payment, home loan options, and the best in mobile banking. PSB, quality community banking since 1925. GJCurbside.com, your complete online grocery store, including local and regional products. Check our website for delivery options. From our curb to yours, GJ Curbside. Ostrom St. Mary, quality healthcare close to home. Lafayette Electric, 1207 Greenwood Street in Morgan City. Proud supporter of high school baseball in the Tri-City area. And Allen's Communications, locally owned TV, cable, internet, and telephone service. Call 384-8335. Thank you for joining us here on KWBJ Live YouTube channel. Please hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe.
Halfway swings, but counts as a strike.
Now batting Carter Fauché.
At the plate is Carter Fauché. Fauché is 0 for 2, grounded out to third, grounded out to short. And this pitch bounces in front of the plate. Evens the count at a ball and a strike.
Fauché came into the game hitting 404.
Well, he bats in the cleanup spot. He's the four-hole hitter. Two balls and a strike.
They could use some cleanup hitter activity at the plate here. Down two, and you're down in your last 6 outs.
Yep, we're in the top of the sixth. There's a fastball, catches the outside corner. Or call strike two, evens the count, 2-2. And just about the whole field is in the shade now. Ooh, looks at call strike three. Fauché goes down looking. One away. That'll bring to the plate the center fielder, Dan Ibert. Ibert is 0-2 as he grounded out to second base twice. He did that once in the second inning and once in the fourth inning. This time he's going to go to short. Landry picks it up. Strong throw to first in time for the second out. Two away. That'll bring to the plate the Tiger catcher. He doubled and scored a run in the second inning and struck out swinging in the fourth inning.
Now batting Ethan Clements.
He'll bat with the bases empty and two outs. First pitch bounces short of the plate for a ball one. Looks at the fastball for strike one. One ball, one strike on Clements. Swings at this pitch. And it's strike, one ball, two strikes. This ground ball to third, makes the catch, goes to first. Short hops, pitcher stays with it. That's Trahan over there at first, makes the catch for the third out. So it's three up, three down. And Maya just continues to cruise along.
Tell you what, he has been in command in this game.
And Abbeville Building and Loan, thank you for your support.
Only scattered a few hits. He's got good defense behind him. This is a solid VC ball club.
It always is, Chris.
It never seems to be a down year here.
I know. I mean, football, baseball, you know you're always in for a tough one when you come to Abbeville. We'll move to the bottom of the sixth inning, where the Screaming Eagles lead the Tigers by a score of 5-3.
Let me mention one more thing about Ralph Sellers Field, and then I'll let it go. Something unusual you don't see often on a high school ball field, especially in South Louisiana, and that is genuine underground dugouts. You have to actually go down a few steps to get into the dugouts here. I think you can't really tell from outside, although they're kind of short from the outside.
Actually, that's why they're called dugouts. I think way back when, they actually were. And Judice will stay on the mound for the Tigers. Going to the bottom of the sixth inning. Eagles have a two-run lead, 5-3, and they'll start off with their five-hole hitter and second baseman, Arvin Bayrow. Bayrow is 0-2. He grounded out to second base in the first and struck out looking in the third. He'll be followed by third baseman Andrew Prejean and then the shortstop Ethan Landry. Bottom of the six.
Lead off for the Eagles.
Arden Bayrow. First pitch misses for a ball. It is a fastball up in the strike zone, but in the strike zone for a call. Strike one. One ball, one strike. Swings at the breaking ball, doesn't catch it. One ball, two strikes. Swing and a miss, and another curveball. Goes down swinging. One away. That'll bring to the plate third baseman, Andrew Prejean. Prejean is 0-2. He reached base on the error in the second inning and flied out to the second baseman in the fourth inning. Fastball, called strike one, nothing in one. Ooh, this pitch on the inside. Ooh. For ball, one ball, one strike. This popped up down the right field line. It's going to be out of play. One ball, two strikes. Third baseman, Andrew Prejean at the plate. Breaking ball, call, strike three. Prejean goes down looking for the second out. Two outs. That'll bring to the plate the seven-hole hitter and shortstop, Ethan Landry. Landry is 0-2 as he struck out swinging in the second inning and grounded out to second base in the fourth inning. and this time gets hit by a pitch. So he'll take first base. That'll bring to the plate catcher, Jacob Dubois. Dubois is 0 for 1 as he had a successful sacrifice bunt in the second inning and grounded out to third base in the fourth inning. So Dubois will bat with one out and one on. We're in the bottom of the sixth inning. Eagles up 5-3 over the Tigers. This pitch is misses high and tight. Dubois pulls his head back just enough to not get hit in the face. Another pitch, almost same spot, has to lean back again. Two balls, no strikes. Judice goes to first. Landry back in time.
That cannot be a pleasant sight, a Judice fastball coming at your head.
No. His fastball's a little bit low for ball three. 3-0. Two outs with a runner on first. 3-0 pitch, misses. Low and away for ball four. So Dubois draws a walk on four pitches. That'll put runners on first and second base. That'll bring to the plate the nine-hole hitter and center fielder, Ross D'Artes. D'Artes struck out swinging in the second, got hit by a pitch, stole a base, and scored a run in the fifth inning.
All right, so the Eagles have a chance to get some insurance here.
Now batting, Ross D'Artes.
Ross D'Artes at the plate, and on deck is Jonathan D'Artes, the leadoff hitter. So umpire is, do we have maybe a pinch hitter?
Pinch runner?
No, I'm talking about a plate. Somebody.
Oh, okay.
Well, I don't know what the umpire was doing there. I thought he was writing something down. Let's see, number seven. Nope, that's D'Artes at the plate. So I don't know what he was writing down, but or what he was doing. Nothing in one. Curveball stays inside. Evens the count at a ball and a strike. Clemens calls timeout.
Courtesy runner for the catcher, Will Seymour.
So we have a courtesy runner for the catcher. Yeah, Dubois is the catcher, so that's what the timeout was about. Swing and a miss. Swing at one up in the strike zone, if it was in the strike zone. One ball, two strikes. Catches the outside corner for a call, strike three. So D'Artes goes down looking for the third out. So a couple of base runners. No runs, no hits. So after six complete innings of play, Hanson Tigers 3, Vermilion Catholic Eagles 5. Tigers need to score at least two to keep this game alive. And they're going to do it, starting with their seven-hole hitter, Reed Lovell. The DH is for the third baseman, Luke Spangler. He'll be followed by Trey Edwards and the second baseman, Spencer Fuller.
This is such a strong district. We mentioned Hanson at number 14 in the state. Vermilion Catholic is number 5. The top five in Division IV Select right now. Opelousas Catholic is number one. Number two, Covenant Christian. That's this district, District 7. Number three, Central Catholic, District 7. Number four, Ouachita Christian. And number five, Vermilion Catholic, District 7. So you've got three of the top five. Absolutely.
Pretty impressive for a little district down here in South Louisiana. A bunch of 1A schools.
And the one public school in the district, Centerville, is currently number eight in Division IV non-select.
This breaking ball misses outside. Ball one. Lovell is one for two on the day. He doubled in the second inning and then grounded out the shortstop in the fourth. This pitch misses up and in. Ball three, 3-0 to count. Gotta believe he's taking this one all the way. He's a seven-hole hitter and they need base runners. And he was. He's looking all the way as it's a fastball. Thigh high. Strike one, three balls and a strike. And this pitch misses outside for ball four. So Lovell leads off the top of the seventh with a walk. Five pitch walk, that'll bring to the plate. Right field, well, he's actually playing second base now. Okay, we're gonna have a timeout. We wanna talk to our pitcher.
Lovell is not your typical seven-hole hitter. He hits 333 and he's smart at the plate. He's not going to help out a pitcher who struggles. And not that DeMaio has been struggling at all, but on that particular at-bat, yeah, he got the 3-0, and he wasn't going to give him anything.
I think he just wanted to settle him down a little bit as he walks his first hitter here in the top of the seventh.
And you know what they say about leadoff walks?
They score a lot. Seems like more than singles that leadoff. Edwards going to come to the plate. He's one for two. He's now playing second base. He started the game in right field. But he singled in the fifth inning, and he grounded to third in the second inning. He looks at the first pitch for a call, strike one. Yeah. It's a breaking ball that stays inside. He just turns enough to avoid being hit. One ball, one strike. His pitch misses low and away for a ball two, 2-1.
Yeah, that inside pitch is when your teammates start yelling, wear it at you.
Yeah. It was a breaking ball. Go ahead and take one for the team. His pitch up high. Three balls and a strike. 3-1 count with nobody out and a runner on first base. Tie and run is at the plate.
And nobody out.
Three-one pitch. Misses outside. Oh, no, he's going to call it a strike. Kind of slowly just moved up and said, strike two. Full count. He fouls it, just gets enough of it to stay alive, fouls it straight back into the fence. Count stays full. Trey Edwards at the plate. Started the game in right field, now playing second base. This is popped up, and it's going to be out of... No, it stayed in play. And did he make the catch?
He caught it, yeah. Third baseman caught it.
That was right on the fence. And I guess it was the third baseman that
made
the
catch. That's
Prejean. Yep. Prejean at third base. Stays with it. Makes the catch. One away. That'll bring to the plate Spencer Fuhrer, who's 0 for 2 in the 9-hole hitter. He grounded to second base in the third. He struck out swinging in the fifth. started the game at second base, now playing short when Jadis moved to the mound. First pitch was a strike, nothing in one. Here's a fastball, catches the big outside corner, nothing in two on Cura. There's a breaking ball for a call strike. And Lovell, or the courtesy runner rather, whoever is running for him, stole second base.
And that play by Prejean kind of got the life back into Maya here. Walked the 7-hole. He had a full count to the 8-hole. Looked like he was going to walk him and deliver, put two runners on base with nobody out, and all of a sudden you get the nice play, and he comes back and throws three strikes, and now you got two outs. They're going to intentionally walk Judice.
Yep, they walked Judice. They hadn't gotten him out yet today. He's actually one for two. He singled in the first. He reached on the error in the fifth, and he drew a walk and scored a run in the third. So he's going to draw the walk here in the seventh. And with two outs, that'll bring to the plate left fielder Lauren Wells. Wells is 0 for 3 on the day. He grounded out to first, flied out to right, and struck out swinging. It's a soft liner right at the shortstop, Landry, who makes the catch for the third and final out of the game as Wells lines out L6 to the shortstop. For the third out.
That's the ball game.
And that is final your ball score. Game, boys and girls.
Hanson Tigers.
Vermilion Catholic Screaming Catholic Eagles five. Will defeat the Hanson Memorial Tigers by a thanks final score out. Of 5-3. Puts the Vermilion Catholic Eagles in a strong position here for first place.
Yep, they will improve to 5-1 or finish the season at 5-1 in district, 17-7 on the year. Hanson falls to 18-10, 3-3 in district. And we were hoping for a good game. We figured this would be a good one. We got what we expected.
Absolutely, Chris. We got exactly what we expected in a good high school baseball game. We knew we would see one, and that's exactly what we got here today. Two good Class 1A schools that both of these teams could and should win a game or two or more as we head into the playoffs.
Yeah, we saw good pitching from both teams, good hitting from both teams, and some strong defense from both teams. I guess that about covers it.
Yeah, they did. Everybody did their job today. I mean, it just was just a good. 5-3, not a whole lot of runs scored, but enough to keep the ball game interesting. The runs were spread out. It's not like last week with the Hanson Central Catholic game. I think we had the final score 6-5, 7-5, but like a whole lot of runs was scored by Hanson, or rather Central, in the first inning. Hanson scored a whole lot of runs, I think, in the second or third inning. And after that, it was one run here or there.
Yeah, they came in bunches.
Right.
Today, both teams kept, they prevented the rallies going. You look across in the board for Hanson, it's score by inning 0-1-1-0-1-0-0. VC got one in the first, two in the third, two in the fifth. So for the most part, the pitchers gave up a little, didn't give up a lot at any time.
Right. So we're going to, you got your sponsors one more
time?
Well,
let's thank our sponsors one more time. Lapco Manufacturing, Taco Bell, Bayou Bend Fitness Center, Conrad Industries, Core Physical Therapy and Sports Performance, Patterson State Bank, GJCurbside.com, Ochsner St. Mary, Lafayette Electric, and Allen's Communications. Tomorrow night, our final regular season game of the season here on KWBJ Live. We'll be coming to you from Matthews as Central Catholic visits Central Lafourche. Listed start time is 6:00. We don't think it's going to quite make that because this is going to be the second game of a doubleheader that starts at 4. We're not going to do the opener, just the nightcap. So sometime, I would think, between 6 and 6:30, most likely. We're going to call it 6 o'clock for now. But join us tomorrow night on KWBJ Live.
Okay, from Abbeville, Louisiana, at Ralph Sellers Field, Como Field, where the Vermilion Catholic Screaming Eagles have defeated the Hanson Memorial High School Tigers by the final score of 5-3. This has been High School Baseball on KWBJ Live. My name is Aaron Ortigo. I'm here from Chris Hunter. We enjoyed bringing it to you. We hope you enjoyed seeing it. Thank you, and come back and join us tomorrow night. We got another good one coming.